The story of the J-35 begins with the ambitious plans of Shenyang Aircraft Corporation, a subsidiary of AVIC, Aviation Industry Corporation of China, long known for developing legendary fighter jets like the J-11 and J-16 in the early 2010s. They initiated an experimental project called the FC-31 Gyrfalcon, a fifth-generation stealth fighter jet that was initially not officially funded by the military. The initial goal of the project was simple yet bold: to create an alternative version of the F-35, but with lower costs and attractive export capabilities for developing countries. The first prototype made its maiden flight on October 31, 2012, sparking a stir in the international defense world. Many Western analysts were surprised. China had developed a twin-engine stealth fighter jet with a modern configuration in such a short time. While seemingly inspired by the F-35, the FC-31 exhibits its own unique characteristics. The jet uses two engines instead of one like the F-35, providing more thrust and redundancy in the event of engine failure. From this point on, the FC-31 began to be known as the dark horse in the fifth-generation stealth fighter jet race. However, despite its impressive design, the FC-31 was initially overlooked by the People's Liberation Army Air Force, PLAF, due to its perceived immaturity and lack of operational readiness. But everything changed when the People's Liberation Army Navy plan began searching for a stealth jet capable of operating from its future aircraft carriers. The FC-31 received a second wind. After years in development, the FC-31 was finally significantly revamped into the J-35, a carrier-optimized military version. This transformation wasn't merely cosmetic, it was a complete re-engineering. The landing gear was reinforced to withstand the high impact of landing on a ship's deck. The wings were now foldable, allowing for efficient storage in space-constrained carrier hangars. The aircraft's structure was made lighter, while the avionics and communications systems were integrated directly with the command system of the Type 003 Fujian, China's most advanced aircraft carrier, which utilizes electromagnetic gliding, EMALS, technology. Now, the J-35 is no longer an experimental project. It is a strategic component of China's maritime air fleet. With the capability of taking off from aircraft carriers, it is capable of conducting strike, air defense, and long-range reconnaissance missions, making it the backbone of China's air power at sea. In many ways, the J-35 marks a major shift in Chinese military doctrine. While previously focused on land defense, it is now ready to project power all the way to the Pacific Ocean, and the J-35 is the spearhead. One of the J-35's main advantages is its stealth capabilities. Its fuselage design features a delta shape with sharp edges, similar to the F-35 and F-22, with trapezoidal air intakes that conceal the engine blades from radar reflection. The aircraft's surface is coated with radar-absorbent material, RMA, a special material that absorbs radar waves, making the aircraft difficult to detect. Furthermore, the J-35 is also equipped with an electro-optical targeting system, EOTS, sensor under its nose, allowing the pilot to passively detect and track targets without having to turn on the radar, which could reveal its position. The cockpit uses a fully digital system, glass cockpit, with a large multifunction screen and a helmet-mounted display, HMD, allowing the pilot to view sensor information directly on the helmet visor, even when the target is out of sight. The J-35's avionics system has also been integrated with Chinese military data links, enabling real-time information exchange between aircraft carriers, and ground radars. That means the J-35 doesn't operate alone, it's part of a network-centric warfare ecosystem. China is building to counter American military power in the Pacific. Despite its impressive design, the J-35's main weakness is still its engines. Early versions of the FC-31 used Russian-made RD-93 engines, which were underpowered and inefficient for a fifth-generation aircraft. However, China is now developing the WS-19 engine, the latest generation of the WS-13 family, with a thrust of around 9 tons per engine. If the WS-19 achieves the desired stability and efficiency, the J-35 will be capable of supercruising flying at supersonic speeds without afterburners, a capability currently only available on the F-22 and some F-35 variants. Furthermore, the new engines are designed with a hexagonal rear section to reduce their infrared IR signature, making the J-35 difficult to detect by heat-guided missiles. The real challenge, however, lies in long-term reliability. China's aircraft engine industry is still in its infancy. While they have shown significant progress, no locally developed engine has yet been fully proven to compete with the US Pratt and Whitney F-135. In other words, the J-35's full capabilities will only be realized if the WS-19 successfully operates stably in real combat conditions. The presence of the J-35 cannot be separated from the geopolitical context of the Asia-Pacific. The South China Sea has become a major battleground between Beijing and Washington. In a region filled with military bases, artificial islands, and armed patrols, China needs an aircraft that can maintain air dominance while suppressing the US fleet's presence. With stealth capabilities and a longer combat range than previous generation aircraft, the J-35 allows the Chinese Navy to conduct offensive air operations from aircraft carriers without relying too heavily on land bases. When combined with the DF-21D carrier killer, anti-ship missile system, and long-range radar, the J-35 becomes a crucial part of China's anti-access area denial, A2A, strategy, preventing adversaries from approaching Chinese claimed territory. Furthermore, there are indications that the J-35 is also being developed for export, primarily for Beijing's strategic allies and clients. If realized, this could be a major step for China to challenge the dominance of the US military export market, which has been dominated by the F-35. More than just an aircraft, the J-35 symbolizes the rise of China's defense industry. In two decades, the country has successfully leapfrogged Russian-based fourth-generation aircraft to a purely domestic stealth design. The project also demonstrates how Beijing is beginning to master the complete supply chain from aerodynamic design and avionics to intelligent weapons systems, something previously held only by the US. The J-35 also symbolizes a shift in China's military philosophy from defensive to offensive. Once focused solely on guarding its borders, China is now actively building its air and naval power to challenge anyone attempting to enter its backyard. The J-35 Gyrfalcon is more than just a new jet, it's a statement of politics, technology, and power. For the United States, it signals that the era of unrivaled dominance in the skies may be coming to an end. For the world, the J-35 is a reminder that the military technology race is no longer dominated by one nation. But the question remains, can the J-35 truly rival the F-35 in modern warfare? Or is this jet merely a shadow of a greater power, a mere symbol of national pride untested in real combat? Time will tell. But one thing is certain, the Pacific skies are no longer dominated by a single color.